Hey there, Nick here from Landbot. Welcome to May's product updates. Let's have a look on what has changed in the last month in the app. First, very important, WhatsApp Business API has made changes on their pricing and types of conversation. We'll go more in detail in just a second. Secondly, we launched a new blog called AI-powered FAQs. Also, you will now be able to add videos, images, and documents in WhatsApp template messages within Landbot. And finally, I'll share three smaller updates from the app. So, let's get into it. Let's begin with the new pricing for the WhatsApp Business API. As you may know, WhatsApp Business API pricing was based on two conversation categories, user-initiated and business-initiated conversations. Meta is now updating and expanding those categories into four new categories. Business-initiated has been unbundled into three new categories. One is utility conversations, like post-purchase notifications and recurring billing statements. Then authentication conversations, for example, messages that help with account verification, account recovery, integrity challenges, etc. And marketing conversations, which include promotions, updates, or invitations for customers to respond or take action. Basically, any conversation that does not qualify as utility or authentication conversation will be a marketing conversation. Then, for the user-initiated category, this one will now be called service conversations. These are the kind of conversations that help customers resolve any type of inquiry they have when they contact your WhatsApp number. So conversation charges will be based on those four categories I just mentioned. Anytime a new template message is delivered, a conversation charge will happen unless they belong to the same category. Other important changes are that the free window for conversations that start from ads that click to WhatsApp and Facebook page CTAs is being extended from 24 hours to 72 hours. Also, the first 1,000 free conversations will only apply for the service category. Now, I suggest you go to the links that you'll find down in the YouTube video description with a full description of each category and a PDF document from Meta that explains the changes with real examples. Moving on, for our second update, we launched a new blog called AI-powered FAQs. Simply paste information from your company and your FAQs here. For example, shipment, refunds, policies, pricing, etc. And ChatGPT will take that information to answer the user in a conversational way. Keep in mind that this blog doesn't have an output and that it's built using OpenAI technology. Like all artificial intelligence, it is not 100% error-free. Hallucinations may occur, occasionally delivering misleading information. This AI-powered FAQs blog is available for web, WhatsApp, Messenger, and API chatbots. Next update, when requesting WhatsApp message templates in Landbot, you'll be able to add documents, images, and videos as headers. Keep in mind that there is a size limit of 30 megabytes for images, documents, and videos. Now, moving on into some smaller updates. You might have noticed that the navigation bar inside Landbot is now extendable. Also, when sending WhatsApp links, it will show a preview if the preview is available for that link. Keep in mind that not all links have previews. And finally, in the buttons block, we have changed the naming of the default output to any of the above. We saw some use it incorrectly. Basically, you should use it to streamline different outputs and avoid unnecessary connections. So that's it. Stay tuned for our next month. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. I'm Nick, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.